you are, dear.
Oh, thank you, honey. Hey, what goes here? Just two eggs? Where's the bacon?
Bacon happens to be 75 cents a pound.
Look, Lucy, I can't eat eggs that way. They look absolutely naked.
Well, look the other way when you eat them.
Now, Lucy, where's the bacon?
As far as I'm concerned, it's still on the hog. I'm economizing.
Well, look, honey, that's a very good attitude, but why do you have to cut down on food?
There's just no other place to cut down.
Is that so, eh? What about all the money that you spend on clothes and the beauty parlor? Hmm? Why don't you cut them out?
Well, all right, if you think you'd like your meal served by an ugly brunette wearing a flour sack.
You know what I mean. There must be some other way to economize.
Well, as a matter of fact, there is, Ricky. Look, save money with a home freezer. Get your meat wholesale.
I knew it. I knew it had to be something being back of all this.
But it won't cost us a cent, Ricky. Look, it says right here, this freezer pays for itself.
Oh, well, let me see. Hey, maybe we ought to get one.
Really?
Sure. As soon as it gets through paying for itself, tell it to give us a call and come over. Honey, I can't afford a freezer, not even one that pays for itself.
But, Ricky, listen, it's only going to save us money.
I can't do it, honey, no. Can't afford it. See you later.
What about your eggs?
Oh, I got a feeling that they won't go to waste. Oh. Ethel is coming up, isn't she? Goodbye.
Goodbye. Good morning, Lucy.
Oh, yeah?
Goodbye, Lucy. Come back, Ethel. If I'd wanted to be with somebody grumpy, I'd have stayed downstairs with Fred.
What's the matter with you?
Oh, I asked Ricky if we couldn't have this freezer, and he says he can't afford it. Can't afford it. I asked Fred to buy us a freezer, too. What'd he say?
I'll tell you what I said.
Please, there are ladies present.
I just come up to tell you not to expect any heat today. I put all new fire brick in that furnace, and we can't use it till the cement dries. This house might be a home freezer itself by night.
Charm boy.
Yeah. See, why is it everything that's wonderful costs money?
I don't know. Say, why didn't I think of this before? Uncle Oscar.
Uncle Oscar?
My Uncle Oscar is a butcher, and he's got a big cold chest.
Why don't you knit him a sweater?
Well, of course, if you don't want to hear my plan.
I do.
Well, he's retiring from the meat business, and he's got a great big old freezer. You know, the kind you walk into and hang up the meat? I'll bet he'd sell us that for practically nothing.
Really?
I'm going to call him up. If we could buy it and put it in the basement, we'd have a real home freezer.
How much do you think he'd sell it for?
I don't know, but there's no harm in asking him, because this would be a great way... Hello, Uncle Oscar. This is little Ethel.
Little?
Uncle Oscar, how much do you want for that big old freezer of yours? For me. Well, that sounds like a fair price.
How much?
He'll sell it to us for nothing.
For nothing?
All we have to do is pay for the hauling and installation?
How much is that?
How much is that?
$50.
Sold! We'll take it. When can we have it installed? This afternoon? Oh, gee, that's fine. Kiss that Emmy for me, will you? Goodbye, Unc. Lucy, we now own a home freezer.
Thank you.